Hi students, now we are going to find out the magnetic field intensity H due to a coaxial cable. Consider a coaxial cable as shown in the figure. Its inner conductor is solid. Inner conductor is solid with a radius A. This is the radius A, carrying a current I. The outer conductor is in the form of concentric cylinder whose inner radius is B. This is the inner radius B and the outer radius is C. It is in the form of a concentric cylinder. This cable is placed along the Z axis. The current is I is uniformly distributed in the inner conductor, while minus I is uniformly distributed in the outer conductor. So, this is the coaxial cable structure. Here, one inner conductor is present and the radius of that inner conductor is A, and the outer conductor is in the form of concentric cylinders and its inner radius is B and the outer radius is C. The current which is flowing through the inner conductor is I, and the current which is flowing through the outer conductor is minus I, which is uniformly distributed. This is the cross-sectional view of the coaxial cable. So, the space between these two inner and outer conductor is filled with a dielectric, say air. Here we are taking air as the dielectric. The calculation of H is divided into variation of regions in the cable. So, we are considering the region 1. Here, the field intensity within the solid inner conductor of radius 0 less than or equal to R less than or equal to A, that is R less than A. Here, we are taking it as region 1. We said that here R is less than A. So, the area of cross-section enclosed is pi r square meter square, and the total current I is flowing through the area pi a square. Hence, the current enclosed by the closed path, here the closed path is here, the current enclosed by this region is taken as I dash. That I dash should be equal to this two cross sections, that is pi r square divided by pi a square into I. So, we get R square divided by A square into I. So, this is the current which is enclosed by the closed path, that is I dash. Here the closed path is showing here. This is the inner conductor and here the radius is A and this is R. And next, H is in the direction of A phi, and it depends upon R. So, H is equal to, you already studied H is equal to H phi A phi. That means H phi in the direction of A phi. So, here also the dl is equal to R d phi A phi. So, the total S dot dl becomes H is H phi A phi dot dl is R d phi A phi. So, here also A phi dot A phi is equal to 1. So, S dot dl becomes H phi R d phi. According to Amperes circuital law, we know the closed integral S dot dl should be equal to the current enclosed. Here, the current enclosed by the closed path is I dash. So, closed integral S dot dl should be equal to I dash. Here, the H is, that is closed integral H phi R d phi, that is equal to, we know the value for I dash, it is R square divided by A square into I. So, next we have to give the integration limits, that is here phi is varies from 0 to 2 pi, that is the closed integral. Here the integral limits is phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi H phi R d phi, it is equal to R square divided by A square into I. H phi r is constant, so we are taking it out, that is H phi r into the integral of d phi, it is 2 pi. So it is equal to R square divided by A square into I. So we get the value for H phi is equal to R square divided by A square into I divided by 2 pi. So that is equal to R divided by 2 pi A square into I. So the value of H becomes, the final equation is I R divided by 2 pi A square A phi ampere per meter. Here the value of R is less than A within the conductor. So this is about the region 1. Next we go to the region 2. Here the field intensity is in between inner and outer conductor, that is A less than or equal to R less than or equal to B. So here we considering a circular path which encloses the inner conductor carrying a direct current. So only one current is flowing through the circuit. So here the value of current is taken as I. We know the equation, that is closed integral S dot dl is equal to I. So here H is equal to I by 2 pi R A phi ampere per meter. This is the equation for region. And next we go to the region 3, that is the field intensity in the annular or outer conductor. Here B is less than R less than C. B is less than R and less than C. This is B. It is less than R and C. So here the current enclosed by the closed path is only the part of the current minus I in the outer conductor. So the current which is flowing through the inner conductor is taking as I, and the current which is flowing through the outer conductor is taking as minus I. So the total current minus I is flowing through the cross section pi C square minus B square. So in this region it is C square minus B square region. Here the current is minus I, a portion of current minus I is flowing through this region. So the closed path which encloses the cross section, that is pi into R square minus B square, this is the closed path region. Hence the current enclosed by the closed path of outer conductor is taking as I dash, and that I dash should be equal to pi into R square minus B square, this is the cross section of that area, divided by pi into C square minus B square. We already discussed this in the former topic, into the current in the outer conductor, that is minus I. So the value is minus R square minus B square divided by C square minus B square into I. This is the value of current which is enclosed by the closed path of outer conductor, that is I dash. The closed path also encloses the inner conductor, hence the current I is flowing through it. So here the current which is flowing through the inner conductor is taken as I double dash. It is equal to the value of current, that is I, the current in inner conductor enclosed. So the total current enclosed by the closed path, I enclosed, should be equal to this outer conductor closed path and the inner conductor closed path, that is I enclosed is equal to I dash plus I double dash. Here I dash is equal to minus of R square minus B square divided by C square minus B square into I, plus the I double dash is equal to I itself plus I. So on simplifying we get the value of I enclosed is equal to I into C square minus R square divided by C square minus B square. Here it is I into 1, we can write this equation as 1 minus R square minus B square divided by C square minus B square, and this can cross multiply. So we get in the next step, that is I into C square minus B square minus R square minus B square, that is minus minus plus plus B square divided by C square minus B square. Here minus B square and plus B square, it get cancelled. So we get the final equation as I into C square minus R square divided by C square minus B square. So according to Amperes circuital law, the value of closed integral H dot dl is equal to the current enclosed by that closed path. Here H is equal to H phi A phi, and dl is also equal to R d phi A phi. So substitute these values, H dot dl is equal to H phi A phi dot R d phi A phi. It is equal to H phi R d phi, since A phi dot A phi is equal to 1. So apply the integration limits, that is phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi. Here we are considering a circular cross section, so phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi. The variation is from phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi. Then h phi r d phi is equal to I enclosed. The same procedure is repeating here also, that is h phi r is a constant, we are taking it out and we integrate this r d phi in this limit. So we get the value h phi r 2 pi is equal to I into the I enclosed value is equal to I into c square minus r square divided by c square minus b square. So from this relation, h phi is equal to I divided by 2 pi r into c square minus r square divided by c square minus b square. So the final equation for h is equal to h phi a phi. So in addition to this value, we are putting a phi here, that is I divided by 2 pi r c square minus r square divided by c square minus b square a phi ampere per meter. This is the value of h. Next we go to the region 4. Region 4, the field intensity outside of the cable, here R is greater than or equal to C. The value of R is greater than C. So consider the closed path with R is greater than C. It encloses both the conductor, that is both the currents, that is plus I, that is I and the minus I e is including in this section, because R is greater than C. Thus, the total current enclosed is equal to, we already discussed that the current which is flowing through the inner circle or inner conductor is I, and the current which is going through the outer conductor is minus I. So here we are considering both currents. So the total current enclosed is equal to I enclosed is equal to plus I plus minus I. So the value of current is 0. Here the closed integral S dot dl is also equal to 0. That means here the closed path contains 0 current. So the value of closed integral S dot dl is equal to 0. So the value of H is also 0 ampere per meter. So the magnetic field, it does not exist outside of the cable. Next, here it is showing the variation of H against R in a coaxial cable. Here it is showing the various regions, region 1, region 2, region 3 and region 4. It shows the variation of R. Here the value of R is in between 0 to A. Then the H is proportional to R here. This axis is showing the value of H. This is a coaxial cable. Here it is mentioning its values, dimensions. So the value of region 1 is directly proportional to R, and in the region 2 is here, that is here the value is in between A and B. So here H value is proportional to 1 by R, and the third one, that is B to C, the region 3, here the value is decreasing, and finally the region 4, it is outside of the value C. Here the value of R is greater than C. Here the value of H is equal to 0, because there is no current is enclosed within the closed path. So here the value of H is 0. it is showing by this figure.